Shaggy's biennial benefit for the Bustamante Hospital for Children in Jamaica.
I dare you.
Gets epic mainstream support.
Shaggy!
Shaggy comes to talk that, as well as the state of reggae in the world,
chop.
Grammy nominations, and his own career.
So difficult.
The male artiste who is on the fire for putting on a dress in quest of dancehall glory.
So fast, I come for fast, and I'm my business.
The name Bella Blair is well known as a vlogger.
We set up so till we make the sun look cool.
Can her brand do the same for her in music?
Hey, yeah.
That is the question she comes to answer.
Anything you can do, I can do it better.
He was one of the international achievers of the 1990s.
Murder, she wrote.
Can what he brings to our stage put him back in that space? Pliers will be here.
You're here to win.
Welcome to the show, everyone. I am Winfred Williams. We'll be right back.
Anything you can do, I can do it better. I can do it better. I can do it.
She's a product of the new age of creative minds who have found their way into the hearts of thousands around the world.
What you want?
Hi, Peaches.
So fast, they come for fast, and I'm a business.
From the comfort of their own homes.
We set up so till we make the sun look cool.
A social media star is who we're talking about.
Tinkerbell.
Yeah.
Her genre is comedy.
Cockroach!
But can her brand do the same in music? That is the question she comes to answer right now, right here on our stage, as she brings her newest project to that end.
Anything you can do, I can do it better.
Her name is Bella Blair, our very special guest right now, right here on our stage. Bella.
Hi.
It's so good to have you.
I know, finally. Oh.
Okay. All right. So tell us about what would you attribute your growth, your achievement to? I know your genre is comedy.
Right.
But what in comedy? What, your material, your style, your topics, what?
I mean, I guess I'm a natural at the comedy thing, you know, vlogging. And I started out, it's a book up, so I started out in university. I was, you know, studying media and communications, a Caramac student. And so I decided to edit something, put it up, and then I started getting a lot of attention from the people, just genuine love, you know. And then I decided to take it on seriously and turn it into a business. Never had a 9-to-5. My comedy skits and vlogging helped me to garner a lot of attention across the world. And so, yeah.
So you weren't giving jokes and receiving laughter before? As a kid in say, high school and so on and so forth?
No, I wasn't that type of person, actually. I was nerdy, but I was always in the arts, in that, in prep school, them fling me in a dance, fling me in a music, fling me in a drama. So I was, you know, I was well-rounded. I was a student of the arts,
okay.
Right, from ever since. From prep school, I got my first gold medal in dub poetry in a JCDC competition, playing drums.
Oh, so you were artsy.
Right.
Artsy girl before.
Right.
So, okay, so you're attributing the success in social media to your natural. You're being natural.
Yeah, and the love from the people, you know? People just genuinely take to me, even if I'm not doing comedy skits, per se. Because, you know, your YouTube channel, you can't just put up anything, talk about anything, and people still show me love from that.
So what do you... How was it triggered? You put out your stuff, you posted something, I take it.
Right.
And what triggered it? A close group, your own friends, started sharing? How?
Well, my kind of didn't popular in my life because, well, I was on, a lot of people don't know that I was on Digital Rising Stars in 2010 and I placed 5th, right? So I kind of had a little bit of popularity going on before.
You had some followers.
Right. So I had like the maximum amount of Facebook friends to my personal page.
Yes.
So when I put out a video, naturally,
so you had a base
to throw it into. And then I collaborated with Trabas in the early years, and that collaboration also garnered, you know, a lot of fans.
Trabas, yes.
Like, holy pop, people come to my set, and I'm like, yes, girl.
So you're looking to transition now to music.
Right.
Because it's your passion.
It is my passion. It is my
passion. Your first passion. And have you done anything about it prior?
Yes. Actually, I was a background vocalist for a lot of artists, Queen Afrika, Tony Rebel, Chris Martin, you know, the works, being in the industry. I actually had a single out with a DJ from Portugal, but it was house music, you know, it was like uns music. That did well in Portugal,
yes,
but you know, nobody really knows of it or knows much about that part of my journey in Jamaica. So yeah, they tried for the music thing before university, but then my mom was like, hey, you have to go to school. And I was like, yes, mom, I'm going to school. So I went to school and I studied media. And afterwards, you know, I just started chasing my dreams.
All right, so how do you sum up your vlogging success?
Boy, it has been such a great journey to just see the love that people can just give to you for just being yourself, for just sharing a part of who you are with the world, you know? I've gotten such attention from people like The Voice out of the UK, even before any newspaper in Jamaica wanted to give me a write-up. The Voice from out of the UK gave me a write-up. And yeah, holy part of vlog sites, the UK, Toronto, the diaspora, you know, the Caribbean, just so much love, you know. And this transition has been kind of rough for me mentally because I know that I have a lot of fans who want to see more of the comedy skits. My DM full, Bella, where you there? Bella, where you there? Put
yes,
you where you there?
But was it, were you able to make a living from your success in social media?
Of course. I've gotten endorsements. I was brand ambassador for Cran Water. I'm still brand ambassador for the Dirty of Jamaica campaign. Yeah, I was able to earn a living hosting events, making appearances in the US, in Canada, all about, yes.
Great. All right. So let's talk about now the transition. So you started last year. You dropped a record last year.
Yes.
And how did that do?
It did well because I'd say I got more attention outside of Jamaica than in Jamaica because David Radigan has been playing Jamaica for so long on his, what you call it, his playlist, that when he came to Jamaica to do a special for BBC One Extra, he invited me on a show and I performed live from him there. I've been getting a whole lot of love from Barry G on Mellow FM and the Mellow FM crew. Listen, I get snaps daily.
All right, so you've come to our stage with a new project, a new music project with video to match and all.
Ah!
And we're going to go, let's go to it right now. I can do it better, I can do it better. Cheat on me, then I'ma cheat on you. But if you respect me, then I'ma respect you. Man of needs, woman of them. You see the sexy girls, but I can see the sexy man them. We could do this sometime. Anything you can do. No, you couldn't ask for a softer threat, okay? Wow, you wouldn't even know it's a threat.
Killing them softly.
Oh my, what a nice little song. Sultry kind of, that's you there, glamour girl kind of vibe.
Yeah.
Soft and can't match hands, but deadly.
Yes, silence but deadly.
Oh wow. All right then, so this is your second single. I take it then that there's a team working with you?
Of course, yes.
In music,
right.
And so now you've shared comedy.
I wouldn't say shed it totally, but it's a fun break now.
So if you put on the gloves and them something, they black out the sun, plus the cream and the gel and them something there.
All right, disclose your background to us. Where are you from? Where were you growing up? How?
I was born, well, I'm from Montgomery Avenue. That's Richmond Park area off Hagley Park Road.
Yes.
And I grew up there, went to Lanaman's Prep. School was round the corner. I was late every morning. Don't ask me how. But yeah, that's where I went to Holy Child High School and then...
And family? What the family structure was like? Big, small,
it was
only
small.
Child?
I'm not an only child. I have a brother. But my mother and my father split around when I was about... When I was young.
Yeah.
But I guess I got over that because, you know, life.
So who
life.
Did you end up with?
I ended up living with mommy. Daddy passed in 2008. That was also a rough period for me. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I live with mommy, grew up with mommy. Mommy is totally supportive of everything I do. And both my parents were free-spirited. And them said, whatever you want to do, whatever your dreams are, chase it. And that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing.
And she's proud of you now.
She is sure. Extremely proud. Trust me. She's extremely
We're proud of you too.
Oh, thank you so
Bella.
Much.
It's so good to have you on our stage. We hope the world watching right now will be as proud of you as we are right now. And we'll consume your music and call you to do performances for them everywhere on the planet, and you get the dream of stardom that I'm sure you're looking for, international fame.
Of course.
All right, so there you have her in this segment of our show, Bella. And still to come right here on stage, Shaggy, Pliers, and dress wearing Dancehall, all coming up. We'll be back. Our guest in this segment is the artist who is under fire for putting on a dress in his quest of dancehall glory. He goes by the name Saul Weatherman, who is right now right here on our stage.
Saul,
blessed love man, welcome.
Nice to have you, nice to have you.
All right, so explain the name first of all.
Well, the name actually came by, at first, me have a name before it, Saul Weatherman, which is J. Saul. So I just take the name, chop the name, the Saul half of the J.
Yes.
And me have a song named Weatherman, the first single that I came out with that did well in Jamaica and abroad.
Yes.
So I just, everybody just starts to say Weatherman. So I just add the Saul, the Weatherman to Saul.
Yes.
And me just run with it.
Call me the Weatherman. Can't control me.
How long have you been in music?
Professionally, I've been in music 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah, but I've been doing music since I've been 12 years old.
And what are your achievements so far?
Well, I have a song right now named Ancat that do great yard and abroad.
So what led you to put on a dress and give the impression that you are gay or transgender or whatever?
Actually, you know, my wife really encouraged me to do this.
Yes.
Because, you know, me and her talk about it. And I said, baby, you want me now? Me have a song. Most of my song, them, whole heap of people know my song. Them.
Yes.
But a lot of people don't know Saul Weatherman.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been always searching for a way to come across the people. So we come to a conclusion here. She said she had do the research to find it. Because I ride down carried in and I was having fun.
Yeah, I heard about you riding a donkey in a
dancehall.
In a dance. So you ride into a dance and a donkey.
This is not the first thing. This is not the first madness.
So these are stunts created?
Yes, generally.
Yep. To get the attention?
Yes.
To yourself or to your music?
Both.
To both?
Yeah. Because remember, right now, me is a musician.
Yes.
So my main focus is music. We come with the song them and make the good song them. But we all know, say, today in our music is have to deal with popularity.
Of who? The music or the artists?
The artists.
If the artist is popular,
yes.
You are saying that if the artist is popular,
yeah.
Their music will automatically be popular
too. You have to have talent. You have to also have talent.
Okay. Yeah. All the big ones that you may look at right now. Let's say Vybz Kartel.
Yeah.
How do you think he got popular?
I would say skin bleaching.
You think so?
I feel so. And all the tattoo.
But he did that last time in bus.
Yeah, but at first, he never get the attention with.
But do you think your boss yet? To you? Because he did that to after in bus, Kartel. Now, what I'm saying is, if you look carefully again, and I'm suggesting that you do, if you look at all the big names in music, be it roots reggae or dancehall,
yeah.
You will see that it is a song that brought them to their fame.
Yeah.
Their claim to fame is a song. Yeah. Not that they're an artist or they talk their way or stunt their way in.
True.
So in most cases, it is the music that drug through the artist, and people like us on stage and so on want to know more about them and go find them and start talking to them. Now, Alkaline is a special case
yes.
because he used the eyeball thing And some need to, some of us need to go back and examine it. Because when he did it and how it helped him was not just on its own. The music was there to back him up, which is, I suspect, is the same approach
have,
you are using.
Yeah, me have time for show the public. Show
so you, all right. So in relation to where Alkaline was,
yeah.
Relate now where you are now with where Alkaline was when he used Tattoo Eyeball.
I'm way past that.
You're better, you're above that in terms of your ascension?
I would say I'm above that with the work that I've put in.
When you assess the body of work that you have now and compare it with what Alkaline had when he did
first,
the eyeball, who is ahead? You are ahead, you're saying?
Yeah, I would say I'm ahead.
Okay.
Yeah,
fair enough.
Yeah.
So you say I don't know. I'm just asking questions.
Yeah, I'm
here. Okay.
Because
so
I did my research. So.
Okay. So you think it's the right time to do the dress?
It's hard.
To have worn a dress.
I mean, it's not saying I could have done it before. No. Mm. I could have done it before because this idea is not something that came overnight. Because the reason why I even did it, because I explained before with me and my wife,
yes.
Said she did a research where she said that I wouldn't be the first person to do it in Jamaica.
Okay.
That's what she told me. So, but I was like...
You mean in terms of dancehall artists?
No, I'm getting to that point.
Okay.
She said I wouldn't be the first person to do it. But my response was I would be the first artist to do it.
So the fear, the homophobia that exists in Jamaica didn't scare you?
No, it didn't scare me. No. It didn't, because, I mean, I know where I stand. I know whatever you do in life.
But who might do you something may not know where you stand.
No, it only take one person to do you something. You know?
Yes,
only
that's
take
right.
One.
That's right.
So that's what my concern is.
Yes.
But majority.
But you needed to attention that much, Saul. But you.
I'm not really scared of nothing still, no, Mr. Winford.
Yes.
I've never been scared if it look. If you look on the man in the video, if
you watch
the video, yes.
You attributed to bravery.
Yes.
Okay.
I've been taking chances throughout my lifetime. So it's puzzling me at first, but I may say, oh, may I do it?
So what happened since you do it?
Whole heap of things. All right. Mm. Tell you something. Before me do this dress thing, people say, frap. Before me do this.
Before you wear the frock?
Yeah. Before me wear it.
Yeah.
A week before me wear it, nobody was actually paying attention to what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
But when me wear it now, a week later, it come like say, me been this big thing for months or years ago. With the same people that me a send song to and where them a get me song. Them never pay it no mind.
Till when you wear the
till
frack.
When we wear it.
So the frack will work then?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so it brought you here, but not because we've heard a lot of your songs. It brought you here
yeah.
Because of the threats you're getting.
Yes, sir.
From some about you wearing a frack in Jamaica.
Yes, Mr. Winford.
Right, so talk about that part there, the threat part, the violence that is being threatened against your life.
It's not only one comments or one call, it's been more than, when did I say, for the first week when I do it, uncomfortable for that first week. They say the following week, I kind of lay back because you see, people for know, say, this dress that I've worn,
yes,
it has nothing to do with anything. Like, may I tell you straight like an arrow?
Yeah, tell me straight that you're straight.
Yeah, like an arrow.
Okay.
So.
And it's just for popularity.
Yes, me just popular.
So what do people who know you well, from your community, for example, your
yes.
Friends and circle of friends, what do they think?
At first, they were shocked.
They're shocked?
They were shocked at first.
Were some of them like, questioning your sexuality?
Never.
They know say straight as an arrow?
Yeah, never.
So them know say do it for the stunt of it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Them know that.
What's your community?
Cartwright Penn, Patrick City.
So you're inner city, ghetto youth?
Yeah, man.
Okay, so you know the sensibility of ghetto people.
Yeah.
You know, means the ghetto people more violent than anybody else, neither.
No.
So, because they can be reasoned with. In many
yes,
cases,
yes.
They can be.
You just have to win them back over.
Win, and you win. You think you have done that?
So that's my main focus.
You're working on it?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
All right, so let's look at one of your video right now. Look, let's go here.
Wine, baby, wine for me now. Take time, time for me now. Slow wine, wine for me now. Back it up, for me now. Y'all know say I'm a shop me end. When you broke from the center, the left to the right. When you wine, 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 wine.
All right, so that's what Saul Weatherman sounds like, right? Wine, wine, wine.
One of my songs.
One of your songs?
One of many songs.
Yeah? Enough sound, yeah?
Yeah, enough sound. I want a different style.
You have a great voice, I dare say, and you sound like an artist, so me don't know why you have to go so far to do what you do, but whatever, man.
Yeah, man, I'm going to big up the man them way, from day one way, Rodwin McCarrier straight, mm-hmm. Body selector, body CD man them, boom, boom. Baddest CD man them, CD banging, and DJ Kenny them, Dan Kingston them, all of them man, the treasure, you see me? Johnny, Jason, them been supporting the career from day one, so I have to give them big ups.
Those are the street support that you have?
Yeah, man, them give me, I have a lot more names, but, you know, call that the next time. But, yeah, man, I big them up, because them say Saul Weatherman from day one.
All right, sir. Yeah, all right, thank you again. Yeah, much respect.
Yes.
All right, there you have him in the segment. Saul Weatherman in the segment of our show. Stay with us. Still to come right here on stage, Pliers and Shaggy.
Can you sing? Sing, sing.
We'll be back.
Girl, you're my angel. You're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps, you are.
He started out as a solo artist. True success didn't actually come until he collaborated with Chaka Demus.
Murder, she wrote. Channel with him, a pretty face and bad character.
As Chaka Demus and Pliers.
Pick up my body and soul, oh girl.
But now he's back to doing solo projects.
Her name is Maxi.
Pliers is here to tell us why he's solo again and brings the latest project.
Blessed.
Good to have you, man.
Yeah, man. Nice to be here again.
Okay, so is it that you're now solo again, fully?
Not really, because me and Chaka Demus still doing shows and stuff like that. Because we have a show coming up on the 16th of this month in England.
Okay.
Me and Chaka Demus, Shaggy, and Maxi Priest.
Got you. So you're only doing shows? You're not recording anymore?
Yeah, we do recording. But right now, Winford is like, it's Chaka Demus and Pliers for a while now, right?
Mm-hmm.
The duo. The people really used to that and love it. But, you know, we have said to ourselves, you know, because Chaka doing the same thing. We're doing a few solos, you know. Mm-hmm. We just figure, say, we're going to just make a little change. Other than on the stage all the while doing combination songs, you know.
Yes.
It's not nice if we have solo hits to can give the people them, you know.
Yes.
Splice up the thing and make the thing a little better, you understand?
Of course, because you guys are always working, eh?
Yeah, you know what I mean?
You're always doing shows. You're never without bookings.
True.
So why not? You're right. You're expanding your catalogue.
Definitely.
And the wider repertoire is the better the performance will
exactly.
turn out.
Definitely. Yeah.
So, all right, so you bring a new project to us.
For
us to look at where you are now in terms of recordings.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go to the screen and look at it.
You're here to win. So fight the end.
Yeah.
You're here to win it. No, never give in. Yeah.
All right. In it to win it, the cool style of Pliers, a characteristic of the Bano brothers. That's very, very cool style, but it's also a deadly style. Winning souls globally.
Yeah, you know,
always.
True.
I see you don't lose nothing, Pliers. It's, you are as cool and as clear and as talented and everything that we know you to have is still very much intact.
Winford is like, you know, a man like me, when you look for me, because I grew up in a country, though, up at Rock Island. It's like, we learn to farm, We learn to have discipline, not those times, manners and respect. And, you know, believe we have trust in our God. Mm-hmm. So we're positive, we try positive, make the mind positive.
Yes.
You know, because you don't know life challenges. You don't know enough time the negative come around to try destroy you. And if you know you do, if you don't strong, you give up. You see the same way you look, fresh and from where I watch you from on stage from them time, you know, change.
Do I? Oh, so thank you.
I just love and the blessing, man.
Okay. And the brothers, of course, tell us, for those who don't know, tell them the names of the brothers.
Spanner, the singers, them. Spanner Banner, yes. Richard Spice, and Snatcher Lion.
Yes, and there's the coolness is from the, your parents.
Yeah,
your father
I think,
or mom?
My mom.
Because you all...
My daddy kind of a bit aggressive.
Is the same among all three of you.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Because even Richie, them just calm and easy and cool and just take life easy.
Yeah.
Them just work. I mean, like, let's take life easy. When it comes to work, we're always willing and up to work. Mm-hmm. Me, personally, I just see myself in other lineage that where me just have a job and me do my job and me not really see the difference. By the time when the thing get very... high and everywhere you go over the world, you can't rest and people don't behind you for pictures and autograph and all them things. We used to have to hide when we go up on the plane. I mean, I don't mind a cup of tea them something different.
The lifestyle. No. The big style.
Plus one go sing. I know so I sing because I my love to my heart. Mm-hmm. That I choose on my life. Do God give me for do I love it. I just want to do it. I just know I'm just a normal man like anybody else.
Yeah, because you've reaped international success with some big tunes.
Yeah.
And how big did these songs get? We're talking about, name the records, Jim, because, you know, you have to remind me.
You have Murder, She Wrote.
Murder, She Wrote, yes.
You have like, She Don't Let Nobody, Murder, She Wrote, She Don't Let Nobody Tease Me.
Yes.
Twist and Shout with Chakademos and Pliers and Jack Radix. Yeah, Bam Bam. What if I tune we have, man, all over the place,
Bam
man.
Bam is used in...
PlayStation 2 or 3.
2 or 3, right.
Yeah. And... Sell millions.
Yes.
I think I should have get something for that because...
yes, that's what I wanted to know.
If me, you guys... know, is a man who sing, who really is my voice upon that record. Mm-hmm.
The particular one used?
Yeah, yeah.
But
yeah,
the original was done by... By Toots.
Toots.
And Sister Nancy mm-hmm. has her own version
mm-hmm,
of it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And the particular one used in the PlayStation 2 or yeah. 3 or whatever.
Yeah, it was.
Is your mine. Voice.
Yeah.
And you were not compensated?
Not
you're
no
not
money.
Compensated up to now?
No, they're not give us nothing. And right now, you know, the last statement we get from the record company is 93.
Which record company is this again?
It was Island Records.
Island Records, mm. right. Because you were signed with Island when you did these big records.
True. Remember, in a Christmas, the album went number one in England, all over the world. All who get at the platinum, like the gold and the platinum thing, them. Mm-hmm. That's all we
but
can
not
show.
The money.
Not the money. But we just keep going on, going on, going on. At least we can find, you know, boss here for give a look at that. I've got to school.
No, man, so you deserve good. More than that. You deserve way more than that. And it's good that you're refocusing the energy on solo work as well. And you're never giving up, are you?
No.
Never.
You're in it to win it. We are trying to motivate the youth them too.
Mm-hmm.
If you know, say, whatever your goal is in life, whatever you set out to do, don't give up. You then come and know how hard it was to me coming up as a youth when me a come to the business. Come me so walk after walk from our town go rock calling. Mm-hmm. 13 miles and anything.
Cause you're in it to win.
All right, Blair, sir. Thank you so much for
thank
coming
you
and sharing with us, sir.
It's a pleasure to sit again and talk to you. Because you're the general.
Oh, well, bro. I don't know that. Well,
no, you are.
Appreciate it, sir.
Yeah, man. Respect,
and,
man.
Keep the cool. The cool is very encouraging and is inspiring,
yeah,
even,
yeah.
That coolness.
That's natural,
and
naturality.
If you research this guy, his work, you'll know that his school is really cool. He's not trying to be cool. He's just naturally cool.
Real.
All right, stay with us. Still to come right here on stage, Shaggy. Need I say more?
Girl, you bring me up just like the sun on the horizon. And even when it rains, I'm enlightened.
Shaggy's biennial benefit for the Bustamante Children's Hospital in Jamaica is getting epic mainstream support for its next staging. Shaggy comes to talk about that, as well as the state of reggae in the world, Grammy reggae nominations for this year, his own career, and more. Mr. Bombastic, right now, right here on our stage. Shaggy, sir. Blessed love, sir.
Mana, sir.
Thanks for coming. Congratulations on the renewal of Shaggy.
But you get better at this, you know. Yeah, see.
I am doing well. Thank you, sir. Congrats.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the big news is Sting.
Okay.
So tell us, how did that come about?
Well, Sting and I did a song. Mm-hmm. His manager used to be my A&R at Interscope, and was also Sting's A&R at Interscope when we were both at Interscope. I've known Sting for years. I've, you know, seen him. We've had conversations back and forth. And I had this one particular song that, you know, his manager liked and played it for him, and he liked, and he was, you know, say, yeah, you do that, you know, I'll jump on it. And we ended up doing the song together.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, you know, there's just having conversations back and forth, and, you know, was telling him about the efforts, what we do at Bustamante here. And he was like, yeah, you know, he'll definitely be involved.
Okay, but, you actually asked him to come on board.
Come on board, and he was 100%, yeah. So yeah, I'll come down there. It'd be his first time performing in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Not his first time in Jamaica, because a lot of people don't know that he wrote Every Step, Every Breath You Take in Jamaica.
Oh, he did?
Yes, it was.
Okay.
There were two other songs to him. It was written at Golden Eye.
Mm-hmm. So how is your collaboration going before we move forward on this?
With me and Sting?
Yes.
It's great. It's an amazing song, and people should be hearing it soon. Yeah.
Okay, so it's not out officially?
No, not as yet.
All right. So he'll be performing for us,
mm-hmm,
in concert or just for a couple of songs?
We'll do a couple of songs, and you know, we'll probably do the new one together and debut it here.
Okay, great.
Be a great place to debut.
All right. So who else is going to be supporting him from the mainstream? I know Wycliffe. Yes.
And Wycliffe, I mean, we can't say Wycliffe is international, yes, but he's been to Jamaica.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's almost Jamaican.
Mm-hmm.
And Fetty Wap.
Okay.
And Fetty Wap, you know, my A&R, which is D. Sonaram, who's been to almost every Shaggy and Friends since we've signed to Sony, and Fetty are working together. And he, who has been here and been around the concert and seen the whole vibe, mentioned it to him,
mm-hmm,
to Fetty. And Fetty basically, we spoke about doing it, and then he came to see me to pretty much assure me that, oh, yes. And, you know.
What do you say about the local support, the local corporate support?
Local corporate support is good. We've lost probably two main sponsors that we normally used to have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with that saying, there are others who stepped up, you know, like a Wisinko stepped, mm-hmm, up.
Stepped up?
Yeah.
Great.
And
Scotia Bank?
Scotia, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they stepped up, so. You know what I mean? But listen, we've been very smart about everything. We get support at the same time, but we have managed it very well at the same time. You know what I mean? That with or without sponsorship, the concert would go on anyway.
There was tear-jerking story yesterday told at the launch.
Very emotional day yesterday at the launch, yeah.
Yes. Talk about it for us. That lady, that mom who brought her son and spoke to. How do you make a link with that and your foundation?
Well, you know, the funniest thing, this all came through Rebecca. You know, my wife actually, I was hearing the story for the first time, the same time as you guys.
Okay.
She obviously had you know, known about it and was a little bit more closer to it, you know. But I was one of the people that in there trying to hold back a tear.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Everybody was teary-eyed.
Yeah, I was one of the people that did it. I said, boy, the way she spoke about her ordeal, and you just can't, as a parent, you can just put yourself in her shoes and just,
mm-hmm,
and just imagine, you know, your child going in there, and it's, you know, when the kid come in and him start vomit blood,
mm-hmm,
and you rush him to the hospital, and the doctor look at him and say,
your child is really sick. Mm-hmm. Your child could die, mm-hmm. right? And we can't get them in to the ICU because there is no beds.
Okay.
There's only 5 beds for the ICU. And, you know, it's by the grace of God that someone came off one of the beds, that he could go on the bed, and that his life was saved. And you heard her in the whole speech, that he was dead.
Yes.
He died, and they brought him back. And you saw him there, and his hand is still kind of messed up, but he's happy, he's healthy. Mm-hmm. And that is what it's about. But she told you the story word for word.
Word for word, yes.
Right? And brought
you through her. She was very articulate.
Right, and brought you through her ordeal.
Yes.
And it brought it back home to those of you who think that, well, we're just doing a concert and we're just put on things and we're just do this, you know, for hype or whatever.
It's a life-saving effort here. Right? When you support it, you're supporting life.
Yeah, it's real, it's real.
You're helping to save lives when you do this. All right, sir. So can we talk about music, the state of the music, a little bit?
Yeah, sure.
All right. So where is our music now, this year? How do you sum up the state of reggae worldwide, reggae dancehall worldwide, in the scheme of international music?
I personally would love to say a little bit more chart action.
Mm-hmm. Mainstream chart.
Mainstream chart action.
Yes.
I think there is a movement, a strong reggae movement going in. I think touring, I see more, especially more of the roots artists, them doing a lot of touring and connecting with an audience on a global scale. Mm-hmm. You don't see much chart action, though. I think probably Sean is probably one of the few chart action you've seen. And that's, you know, with a lot of his collaborations.
Yes.
You know, before that, the chart action was I Need Your Love, that I did mm-hmm. you know, 2-3 years ago. So I would love to see a lot more of that.
Of that.
Because it makes us a force to be reckoned with. But as far as reggae itself, and especially that traditional roots reggae, there's definitely a movement that is going on. And it's a conscious movement. And it is definitely getting a lot of attention and getting some fans.
A surge is taking place at the moment.
Yeah, you can feel that. You can feel that energy going.
That energy, and it's a global energy.
It is a global energy.
In which Jamaica is playing a bigger part than it used to.
Yes, but it's not playing a part as far as pop music is concerned.
All right, talk a little bit more about your own career now, Shaggy. Quickly about where you are now in the scheme of things.
I have an album coming out on Sony. I've been working on this album for the longest and keep changing it. We put a couple of singles out from I Need Your Love to Only Love to That Love to all of these songs. You know, I Got You, all these songs. And finally, I'm putting a record out in February.
Okay. The nominations for the Grammys. Mm-hmm. Grammy 2007. What do you make of the nominations? Chronix, Junior Gong, Morgan Heritage, Jay Boogs, and I can't remember who else.
In fairness. In fairness, I've only listened to 2 albums out of that batch. I've listened to the Chronix album and I've listened to the Junior Gang album.
Like most Jamaicans, right? Yes.
I didn't hear the J Boog album, I didn't hear the Morgan Heritage album. So they could very well be very stellar albums. I have no idea. I can't comment on that.
Yes. I am guilty of that too. Right. Go ahead.
With both albums, it will be interesting to see. Mm-hmm. What come out between Chronix, because with Chronix at this point is clearly the crowd favorite.
Locally, you know, or locally, internationally?
Locally. Definitely locally is the crowd favorite. I mean, mm-hmm. you see him, he pack these concerts, he has a movement going in Jamaica right now. Mm-hmm. People are feeling it. Funny enough, there's a lot of Wilpa Hopton people too.
Oh, yes.
Huge. I was surprised.
That's interesting, right?
Yeah, very interesting to see a lot of Hopton people that is really moving.
Onto him, yes.
Right. I still think the streets is still on, like, you know, Cartel and Idone and people like that. Mm-hmm. You know? But he's definitely the crowd favorite, you know, and where Gang now has an album that is out, but it would be interesting, it's neck and neck because he has more of that international appeal, obviously.
He's got a bigger global brand.
Yeah, he's a global brand. He's been around there for a while. People know him. He's associated with a very, you know, famous, credible name in reggae music.
It's the most powerful name in reggae.
Yeah. Marley. So, you know, it is, it going to be sticky.
Why, you know, people love to pitch up.
Yeah. So we have put the money upon.
So you careful, you have to be careful.
we have put the money upon.
Well, I don't know. I'm not going to take one. All I know, I'm excited about this.
Wouldn't it be funny if it's not none of them that get it?
That now is where Jamaica would be enraged. We would be marching on NARAS, the Grammy Foundation, for women's
getting. They're not marching.
No disrespect
one day.
To the rest.
Yeah, tell
to,
you that. If, to it, tomorrow, if tomorrow morning Jay Boog or anybody else get it,
yes.
Jamaica now march nothing. Nobody stands up and make a noise and make a voice. I've actually had meetings with the Grammy Association about the record Grammy and all this gone. And the fact is, a lot of them just don't, people don't register.
Yes. They don't
register.
We need to pay the $100 per annum.
Yes.
To get
register.
A vote.
Yes.
The Jamaican people with the credentials.
Yeah, I vote.
The creative credentials.
Yeah.
Should go, meaning artists to release work and producers.
Register on yourself.
Musicians.
So that you have a voice.
I think we should
When you see it gone, so tar, you know, East or South or wherever, no, we're not going to write. A year fast.
You appreciate it, sir.
Shaggy and Nobody Friends, knows January 6th. January 6th, Shaggy and Friends, make sure to come.
Sting. And the tickets are available. To talk about your early bird and those.
My early bird options are 6,000 for silver, all right? 12,000 for gold, and 25,000 for platinum.
And that cuts off when?
Right, early bird. And that cuts off on the 24th.
Shaggy, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you for the platform again.
All right. It's always yours, sir.
Yeah.
It's always yours.
All the best.
All right. So there you have him right here on stage. Shaggy, the real big man in music. Nobody knows it like him, eh? Winford Williams, on behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more on stage.
I bet you we should never burn that bridge. I bet you we should never burn that bridge.
Oh no, and now you like to cross it.
I bet you we should never burn that bridge.
Oh no, cause now you like to cross it.
I bet you we should never burn that bridge.
Oh no, and now you like to cross it.
Climbing up the ladder, you better watch your step.
I show you a fix, so watch the moves you make.
Careful of the people you disrespect.
There will be repercussions, my life did not change.
Cause when you're coming down, they might not wanna treat you right. And when you're coming down, that's when you are gonna get to fight. And now you're wishing that you were a little more polite. And now the table's turned and everything has come to light. I bet you wish you never burn that bridge.
I suspect you like that video. For more, click and be on our stage always.